Greetings, fellow worldlings. Welcome back to Pink Panther and Passport to Peril. Actually, I just looked up the title of the game and it's Pink Panther's Passport to Peril. Doesn't really matter though. Yeah, we've already... Well, I guess I didn't show you guys that I talked to him already, but this guy is losing his stuff. And yeah, I realized that these games are made for children, so I can't swear anymore. Unless I want to educate them about swear words. In which case, I probably could. Anyhow, if any of you adults are listening into this, I thank you for coming over. Now, kids, what's going on here? Why is Camp Chilivava in the water? Does Pink Panther see something in front of him? Yes, he does. What is it? It seems to be some kind of footprints. Yeah, I'll stop that.
These prints in the mud look suspicious. They're leading out towards the jets.
No shit, genius. Do you want to say something?
Von Schmarty, I found some strange prints in the mud over by the lake. I think it's some kind of clue.
Don't be too hasty, Pink. You can't chase every dog that barks.
Peculiarly worded, every dog that barks, eh? And are we supposed to click here again?
Von Schmarty, you know I have great respect for you, but are you sure we're not overlooking those strange prints by the lake?
You want to be the big man? You go ahead! You don't need my help! You never listen to me anyway! I'm through helping you! Leave me alone!
Well, someone's having a bad day. Anyway, let's follow the prints then.
I can't help but think those prints are a lead.
Good job, Pink. Good job. Which plane do these prints go to? Does it go to the Bhutanese plane? No, it does not. What about the Indian plane? Well, it goes beyond that. How about the British plane? Nope, the prints don't really go to the British plane either. I guess the only place that's left to check is the Aussie plane. There's this red flag there which I haven't seen before. What happened to the rest of the houses? The entire houses are missing. I just want to check this quickly. Nothing, as expected. Alright, let's head over to Australia.
It's not much of a lead, but it's all I've got.
So this might just be the final chapter of the game, and in case it is, yeah.
Please take your seat and fasten your seatbelt. The aircraft will be moving shortly.
Now, why can't I sit there? There was the person who came before me was sitting in there.
Big day for wildlife travel. First the croc, now the panther.
Croc? What? Hey, I didn't do that.
Hello, Pink Panther, and thank you for flying Air Schmarty. We'll be cruising at an altitude of 42,000 feet today. Once we finish our climb, you can remove your seatbelt and move freely about the cabin.
Alright, let's remove the seatbelt first, and I want to read this dossier.
Cutthroat entrepreneur scores prime real estate? Huh. The notorious DOG has struck again, this time ousting longtime residents of Happy Farms retirement home from their sprawling acreage. He's unstoppable. Happy Farms director reported, once he has his mind set on a property for his dog burger restaurant, you may as well pack your bags. Dog burger restaurant? At Camp Chilliwawa? Could it be?
I guess that was his plan. I mean, we saw him doing that.
Are you sure this thing is on, Pug?
Positively. Just to be extra safe, I'll turn the volume way down.
Now this time, we're sure to get it right, man.
Yep. We'll apply what we learned from the last time and keep our identities hidden.
He won't even know it's a hijacking.
Well, we'll just keep on flying round the world. He'll never get in the dog bar this far again.
And there's no way he can escape!
That's right, Louie. He would never be smart enough to use the parachute again. Even if he was, he would never think to wait 10 seconds before pulling the cord. So he doesn't get stuck on the jet and all.
Yeah, so it's pretty obvious what we should do here, but I like the interior of this plane. I mean, it's very well decorated. I wish more planes had interiors that were decorated like this. Yep, it would be expensive, but it makes the ambience really nice. Kids, ambience is the word for the feel of a place, the mood that a place sets you in. Remember that, kids. That's the word for today. Alright. Yeah. Huh, those guys are stupid, aren't they? Beautiful horizon there. Looks like a sunset. I love this music. And the Pink Panther landed in the water.
Can you give me a hand?
My people have always extended their hand to the white man, but have only been betrayed in return.
What about the pink man?
We never had pink.
I promise I'll bring no harm to your people.
Bring no evil goodies either.
Evil goodies?
Cigarettes, alcohol. Joni loves Chachi reruns. My people knew nothing of these perils until...
I promise I'll bring no harm to your people.
Well, that's a boring community. But again, I mean, I suppose it is the way of life to wish to not be disturbed by external influences and stick to their own traditions and methodologies. What is this?
That is called a dendroglyph. The carving on the tree marks the burial place of a loved one. Some Aborigines mummify their loved ones and bury them in a place like this.
So I didn't know that Australian Aboriginals also had mummification rituals. That's interesting. I honestly was looking forward to coming to Australia, and it's quite nice. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna touch that, but oh well. That is one way to cross that thing.
A lot of bugs!
I mean, he is the Pink Panther after all, so I doubt it would be too much of a hassle for him. Why have we come back again?
Up there are eucalyptus leaves, the koala's favorite snack.
Ah, yes.
That bark is our canvas. We paint on tree bark and use it for many other useful things.
Australian Aboriginals, huh? I wonder how many Aboriginals are still in Australia. Do you have anything? Oh, this. I guess it will become a piece of key evidence later on in the game, during the final chapter, I suppose. And I guess I cannot touch that thing yet. Any other trees that we need to touch?
That is the mark from where my canoe was carved. We take only what is needed. We do not destroy the whole tree to make one small canoe.
That is quite responsible indeed. And I guess I can only touch you now.
You look like an agile panther. Would you mind fetching some witchetty grubs for me?
It's the least I can do to repay you for rescuing me.
I guess this is where we get to learn about all the animals that Australia has to offer.
I'm a duck-billed platypus. Is it me or am I unusually funny-looking?
I mean, when people initially started talking about the discovery of this brand new animal, which is the duck-billed platypus, nobody believed them. Everybody thought that they were talking about something from the myths. Because this thing, it has a tail like a beaver, it has feet like ducks, and it has like a snout like a duck, and the rest of the body is like a rat. So people used to think that this guy is probably a mythological creature that they're... What was that?
Howdy! Got a question about the bush? Ring the bell and in I whoosh!
Where can I get some witchetty grubs?
In a witchetty bush. You dab at the roots with a pointed stick until you feel them give. If they do, there are witchetty grubs free for the spearing.
Thanks.
I'm a marsupial. That means I tote my wee ones in a pouch. Well, not just any pouch. My pouch. You wanna see? Joey, get out here!
Yeah, Ma?
Is he adorable?
Ma, you're embarrassing me.
I mean, marsupials in a human context would be very, very disturbing. In a very private sort of manner. I'm guessing this is how we get the stick.
I would give my left paw for some eucalyptus leaf.
Ah, see. Since we have a crossover anyway.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm psyching myself up over here.
For what?
For that huge mound of termites.
Okay.
I'm a frilled lizard. I'm in a terrible rush. I'm not dangerous. Can't talk. Gotta run.
All right, then. Eucalyptus leaves.
Potent.
They smell amazing, though. Eucalyptus leaves, I mean. All right. Eucalyptus leaves for the koala.
My prayers are answered!
That must have been one heavy branch. Now where...
I'm psyching myself up over here! For that huge mound of termites! Mouth-watering, ain't it?
I see. Anyhow.
Howdy! Got a question about the bush? Ring the bell, and in I whoosh!
Where can I get some witchetty grubs?
In a witchetty bush! You dab at the roots with a pointed stick until you feel them give. If they do, there are witchetty grubs free for the spearing.
Thanks.
Oh, so I guess we're supposed to poke around the bushes? Maybe these bushes here? Most likely. Witchetty grubs indeed.
Yes! Grubs galore! I win!
Now what? Now right here. What? Oh, okay. Since there's a wallaby or a kangaroo standing in the way, I can't tell which one it is. Most likely wallaby given the size, but you never know. Kangaroos tend to be human-sized, and this thing is a human-sized, so maybe it's a kangaroo and not a wallaby. They just said marsupial, which is a general term for any kind of animal that has a pouch.
Have some. It's kangaroo. Children cannot eat kangaroo meat. It gives them nightmares.
Really? Why is that?
Because that way there's more left for the adults.
I didn't know they actually ate kangaroo meat. But then again, I mean, it's sort of human tendency to hunt and eat whatever they can get their grubby paws on. There's a croc here as well. Interesting.
Guess which panther won't be spending the night in the slow roaster guest bed.
slow roasted guest bed. Boomerang. Remember, children, life is like a boomerang. What goes around, comes around. Do not forget that. Once more for demonstration.
Change your mind?
I guess that's a kangaroo meter.
Did you grab my grubs?
Yes, I did. Could not have come here without it. Well, this guy's happy.
Ah, thank you. I knew you would provide.
So, larvae, like the kind of grubs that this guy ate, they're actually a very nutrient-dense source of protein.
This is our totem. Those are our sacred animals, and they cannot be hunted in these woods. Our ancestors passed them on to us from our dreaming.
Dreaming?
The dream time. Find one of these for yourself, and I will play it for you. Teach you about our dreaming. This instrument is called a didgeridoo. It's made of hollowed wood.
So is it really called a didgeridoo? That sounds like something along the lines of whatchamacallit or thingamajig, you know? One of those placeholder names that people like to use. Anything else here?
Where's your didgeridoo?
Yeah, I need to go get a didgeridoo now. I guess we go back then. So who do I call now?
Oh, thanks, Panther. I owe you big time.
I'm a mammal with reptilian tendencies. I lay eggs like a bird or a lizard, but I also nurse my young.
So exactly one of the reasons why this thing was believed to be a marsupial. Sorry.
I'm all grubbed
stuff
out.
Stuff of mythology. The stuff of myths and legends.
At peace with nature.
As you can tell, was that you that rang my bell?
Say, what is a flidgery-spoo? I mean a Kalamazoo. a wizzery-foo. An herbal shampoo.
You mean a didgeridoo. It's a musical instrument made from an enormous hollow tree branch. Sounds like this.
Oh, right.
Toodles!
So now we need to find an enormous hollow tree branch, is what we need to find. Question is, where do we find it?
I'd do anything for the kid, honest. You know, it's very dry in Australia. Sometimes there isn't enough water to drink. I let Joey drink my saliva right from my mouth.
Now that's love.
Yeah, koalas have it worse. When koalas are babies, they can't digest the leaves yet. So what they do is they will lick up their mama's poop right from the source. The secretions that they secrete along with the poop, which sort of gives them the ability to digest eucalyptus leaves as they grow. And the worst part about koalas is the fact that eucalyptus is the least nourishing thing for them, but they still only have eucalyptus. These guys are so dumb, they can't even tell that eucalyptus leaves are eucalyptus leaves unless and until it is on a branch from the eucalyptus tree. So yeah.
It's still not a didgeridoo. It needs to be hollowed.
So I need to find something to hollow it with, I suppose. Now where do I get something like that? Can't exactly use the dug-built platypus there, can I?
I'm all grubbed out.
I'm a beaver, I'm a duck, I'm a fish, I'm a bird, I'm Phyllis Biller. Oh, it's confusing.
Mouth-watering, ain't it?
Not exactly. Say, can you carve wood?
I leave that to the little guys.
Too bad.
Hey!
Ready, set, lick!
Well, that's nice. That was dirty. The Pink Panther swung to them dirty. I just want to look at this picture again. Man. That is a cursed picture. It's just one of the few things that I love about these Pink Panther games. They're just so out of pocket in so many ways.
Mites don't fail me now. Fancy chewing, guys. Thanks.
He shot the mites out like a shotgun. Back to the campus, and we'll play the didgeridoo and probably have like a weird dream in the form of a musical, and then we should be able to head on with our journey.
Now put your lips around it and blow while I tell you of our dreaming.
That sounds exceptionally dirty, but okay.
History is drafted down on paper. We keep our legends in a place we feel they will be safer. Many moons ago, in a time that we call dreaming, our ancestors paved the way and showed us nature's meanings. Dreaming in the dream time, our history is this land. Passed on to us from our dreaming time.
Dreaming in the dream time, our history is this land. Dreaming in the dream time, look close, it's in my hand. Dreaming in the dream time, our history's told in story.
tradition stems a tale. We whisper chants into the winds and across our lands they sail.
For over 40,000 years we danced beneath the hot sun.
But when the settlers first arrived, they claimed this land belonged to no one.
In the dream time, people could change into their totem animals when they needed to or wanted to.
Really? So you mean if one of your people wanted to change into, say, a crocodile, it could be done?
In the dream time, certainly. Today, it would take a spirit very connected to their dreaming to accomplish such a thing.
Do you think Kumokin is capable of such a thing?
I used to think so. When he was a boy, he only knew our people, our land, our language. Now he wants to live in urban cities, go to special coldy camps, and drink Wawa. I don't know. He has not yet been traditionally initiated into manhood. And if he never is, he cannot ever truly carry on his heritage.
Well, what do you mean by initiated into manhood?
We have our customs. We have our traditions.
I didn't mean to pry.
I am sorry. You do not understand what has happened to our people. This land was ours before Australia was colonized. Us, Aborigines, as you call us, served this land. This was our kingdom.
Five 100,000 Aboriginals lived on this land when white men arrived. Half that many were murdered. Today, we are only 1% of the population in Australia.
We
have always embrace strangers. The first white people to arrive at our land were not settlers. They were prisoners.
Prisoners?
Our people accepted the white man's outcasts. In return, they attempted to exterminate our race. Like what happened to the Tasmanians. Completely extinct.
And so you feel that when your child strays from his homeland...
He is helping to complete the genocide. We must keep our history alive. It was not so long ago that white men took our children from us, forced us to live on reserves, took us there in chains, beat us for speaking our language, and for practicing our religions, infected us with their foreign diseases, broke our spirit.
I'm sorry.
For what? You didn't do anything. You don't have any strange diseases, do you?
If being long, pink, and single is a disease, then don't even try to cure me.
Uh-oh.
And here's the guy we keep looking for, I suppose.
The croc.
Kumokin, I know his eyes.
He traveled here from Camp Chili Wawa.
Kumokin's spirit. There is something wrong at the camp. There is danger where Kumokin has come from. He says you are needed at that place.
Tell Kumokin I'm coming. I'll call my jet. Don't worry, I'm a secret agent. Your son is in good hands.
I know he is, Pink Panther.
How did you know about him? Oh, damn. What's going on here? Yep, told you, these guys were robots. Look at this girl here. Look at Indrani right here. They're all robots, every single one of them. And so is Ananda. Young Lee, though, is just sort of enjoying, I suppose. That's a blueprint, isn't it?
This should come in handy later.
But now let's just head down and deposit the evidence that we have. Let's hope it's still there, though. What is that? We can't even interact with it.
Secret hiding place.
Let's hope it is as it remains as secret as it once was. I don't think we need to keep that there. This, however, does belong here. Let's try this one as well, just for the sake of trying. I don't think it'll. What is that though? Should I keep it down here? Doesn't do it, I suppose. Actually, I can't even read it, so might as well keep it down here. Can I interact with this now? Apparently not. It's like Doomsday out there. Young Lee! Oh yeah, the flag is already waving about up there, isn't it?
Don't count your chickens before they're hatched, Dogfather. I'll be needing this for evidence.
Good to know that is actually evidence. Let's talk to these children first.
Hi there, little fella.
Indrani, maybe?
Is it fall yet?
That girl there, where did I see you?
Try and catch me. You're it.
Oh, damn. And there's Nigel there.
Sorry I was nasty before. Why don't you go for a swim? Go for a swim!
That's water? My god.
Yikes. So that's what happens if you don't wait an hour to swim after eating.
And there's some light here. So how about we deposit the evidence before we get there? That might just be where the final act of the game takes place. Who knows? Or maybe it's right here. Anyway, we're going down. Back down there. Come on, hurry up. Haven't got all day yet. Let's hope all of this does not get, taken away. I don't know why, but I just have a bad feeling about keeping all the evidence, all the eggs in one basket. That's the toggle right there.
I said when the time is right!
I can't pretend that everything is okay anymore. I'm cracking up.
No one goes anywhere until all my plans are finalized.
I'm warning you. I'll tell Pink Panther. Then you'll be in deep water, worse off than the real kids, if you know what I mean.
Okay, where are the real children, you canine trickster?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Pink Panther.
That's right, boss. Boy, you've got real nostrils to pull a stunt like this.
I had to go along. He blackmailed me. He said he would turn the children into dog burgers, I swear.
Kidnapping the children and planning to turn Chili Wawa into one of your lucrative dog burger restaurants? How low can you stoop?
This low?
You're gonna get locked away for this.
Oh, yeah? You can't prove nothing.
Can you?
You ain't got enough evidence to convict me, Panther.
I must have overlooked a piece of evidence somewhere. I'll find it if I have to turn this whole camp upside down.
Head into the aerodrome and check for evidence there. I don't think there is any evidence here, though. Interesting. What is that? That boarded up section of the wall down there. This place is sort of dilapidated. I don't know why it's flickering like that, but oh well. What is that? Yikes. Is that just a cloud? I hope it is. It just came over for dramatic effect as well.
Holy socks and sweaters! It's worse than I expected! I better take one of these for evidence.
Any more?
It lights up.
Alright, secret evidence, please. Can we not put it here? Is it like overstuffed or something? I suppose. Wait, not this one. This one. Right, that's the evidence. The other one was just a bulb. Like, let's go ahead and pick up all the evidence.
This should be enough to convict him!
Ah, that's what I needed to do, apparently. Just tell me that I need to bring the evidence. I mean, I thought we were supposed to store all the evidence here. Anything here? Nothing, I suppose. So, at this point, I don't really know whether this is the last video or whether I'm gonna make this into a separate video, but here we
go. You're gonna get locked away for this.
Oh, yeah? You can't prove nothing,
can you?
I found a little article written about you in Private Jet Quarterly. Not to mention your premature sailing of the dog burger flag. And the evidence I uncovered proving that the kids aren't really kids at all. Remote controlled robots, dog dad? Pretty clever. And then there's this blueprint outlining your plans to turn Camp Chili Wawa into one of your lucrative dog burger restaurants. Plus, this decoded hieroglyphic note that tells me the real Chione is having a great time, wherever she is.
Not to mention this phony postcard you forged to Nigel's family, riddled with spelling mistakes when Nigel is a champion speller.
My plan worked perfectly. I programmed the robots to hate Camp Chilliwawa no matter what happened. Now the Better Camping Bureau has shut the place down and I can open my restaurant as soon as the paperwork goes through. Would you like some fries with your burger?
There will be no fries, and there will be no burgers! I'll find the real kids and turn you in!
I won't hold my breath.
I wish you would.
Go on, get him!
What about the evidence? I guess this is where we use the lamp. I'm glad this is not a time-based game, otherwise it would have been so difficult. The evidence, so I need the evidence. Oh no, the evidence is going to be left behind.
There he is! Get him!
Handing the bat by the evidence is such a brainless move.
I gotta hide somewhere.
Down there, most likely. Did you see something down there? No, that's Dr. Schmarty's. Right. But I still can't use this, so I guess we'll hide down there. The bulb is gone. Oh, right.
Works perfectly as an overhead light.
All right, Dr. Schmarty's stuff.
Oh no, the battery's dead.
How about we use it with this here then? Yeah, that's not gonna work. You're gonna need an extension cord, aren't you? Now we get to select that.
Now we're cooking with gas!
I guess I'm up for a little game of hide and seek.
This guy's trying to be Schwarzenegger, huh? This one guy right there.
Fee, fi, fo, fares. Methinks I smell a big nose beneath them stairs.
That's a camping charge. Then there's this guy there.
Marco?
Hello!
Where are the others, though? There should be two more somewhere here.
Come out, wherever you are.
Nobody's hiding in the smokestack, man! Everybody's busy hiding in other places! Come again some other day!
You'll see what I see there. An overzealous wagging tail. Yeah.
You dirty, dirty dog. Now I just need to find the kids.
Now, the question is, where could the kids be? In the water? I mean, they did hint at that, so... No wonder they don't like them.
We were trapped in a bubble, but now we're free to go back to our friends and families. We didn't know what happened, we were taken by surprise. Camp Chilliwawa disappeared before our very eyes.
Distracted by toys and games and fun, we prayed the plan would come undone.
We were trapped in a bubble, but now we're out.
So I'll sail off on my airboard,
and I will scream and shout.
The danger brought us closer. We shared a grief.
If we could do this,
we can do.
I heard about what you did over there, Panther. Most impressive. You realize you'll be decorated for all this?
I had suspected as much.
I had an overwhelming number of requests for your services this morning, what with the news just out.
I see. And have you selected my next assignment?
Very dangerous.
Of course.
Assignment entails high combat, espionage, and fish sticks on Wednesdays.
Fish what? Sticks on Wednesdays?
That's right, Panther. Undercover lunch lady. I've already ordered your hairnet. It's a cutting-edge school. They've implemented the spark. Close-minded Panther, a job is a...
job!
And that was that for Pink Panther in Pink Panther's Passport to Peril. I mean, I sort of feel like I'm not the intended demographic for this game. And, I mean, I'm about to be 30 in a few years now. So... yeah, but at the same time, I mean, the puzzles did get better towards the end, especially when the thriller part started kicking in, and yeah, but for the rest of the game, it's like the puzzles didn't really hold your hand much either, so it was like pretty difficult for the most part, and let me just mute that. You know, just so that I can speak, I can hear myself speaking. But anyhow, yeah, towards the end, it was entertaining, but especially near the start of the game, it was just a little too educational for my taste. And that's a theme that remained constant throughout the end as well. Just that it didn't exactly sit well with me. So, yeah, it's not really a bad game. It's a good game. Just that I'm a little too old for it. And the only reason I played it is so that I could play the prequel to one of my favorite childhood games. Speaking of, I don't really know how I might find that game at this point in time either. I don't think it had any musicals. That's another thing about this game that I did not like. I absolutely cannot stand musicals unless they are of pretty good quality. Educational musicals, please keep it away from me. So, yeah, still, despite the fact that I found it a little boring, it turned out to be good towards the end, even though it felt a little rushed. Then again, I can't really expect much more from a children's game. But it was a pretty nice story over all in all. And yeah, that's that for Pink Panther's Passport to Peril. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end of not only the finale, but also the entire playthrough. And the screen is black right now, probably because it's the end of the program. So, let's see here. Yeah, it just shows me like a wait sign there. And there's some music there as well. I don't know if it's going to get me a copyright strike, but I hope it does not. I'll just keep it muted for now. I mean, not a bad game. Not a bad game at all. Just not my cup of tea. And yeah, I'll just do my favorite childhood game of justice and cover that, and I guess I'll be calling it quits from any of these point-and-click adventures. These kinds of point-and-click adventures with cartoon logic that don't really give you much of a hint about how to proceed forward, and the solutions just are just out of this world. Extraordinary. You know? So, the solutions aren't really intuitive at all, unlike the Silent Age that I played before. And quite a few other more realistic point-and-click adventure games. So, yeah, when we come back, we will be covering Pink Panther in Hocus Pocus Pink. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.